In this video, we are going to discuss about keywords in Python programming. Keywords are predefined words or reserved words whose meaning is already fixed. So we can use the keyword for that purpose only. It is not possible to change the meaning of a keyword. Here we cannot use a keyword as an identifier. That means it is not possible to use keyword as a variable name or function name or class name or object name. Python supports totally 33 keywords. So we have 33 keywords in Python programming language. Now let's see all the keywords one by one. The first keyword is true, second one is false, third one is none. So in these three keywords, the first letter is uppercase letter. So in true, T is uppercase letter. In false, F is uppercase letter. In none, N is uppercase letter. So remaining three are lowercase only. So RUU is lowercase, ALS is lowercase, ONE is lowercase. Here keywords are case sensitive. Case sensitive means there is a difference between lowercase and uppercase letter. So except T, F and N, all are lowercase letters only. So in F, all the alphabets are lowercase. In Elif, all the alphabets are lowercase. Okay. Now let's see all the keywords. The first one is true, second one is false. True and false are nothing but Boolean values. We know what is a Boolean value. Boolean value may be either true or false. True means 1, false means 0. The result of any conditional expression is a Boolean value. Now let's see about none. None indicates that the corresponding variable has no value. The corresponding variable has null value. We can declare like this: A is equal to none. So in none, what is N? N is uppercase letter. So it specifies that A has no value. That means A has null value. Next one is if. It is just like what we use in C, C++ and Java programming language. If is a conditional control statement, it is useful in order to check whether the condition is true or not. If the condition is true, then the body of if will get executed. Whereas if the condition is false, then the body of else will get executed. If there is more than two conditions, then we use elsif ladder in C, C++ and Java. Whereas in Python, in place of elsif ladder, we use elif. So that elsif is simplified as elif. So this elif specifies elsif. So if there are more than two conditions, then we use elif. So if the first condition is false, then this elif condition will be evaluated. Again, if this condition is false, then the next elif condition will be evaluated. So elif is similar to elsif that we use in C. Next one is else. Else, if the condition is false, then the body of else will get executed. So next three are AND operator, OR operator and NOT OR. Next three are AND keyword, OR keyword and NOT keyword. So AND is similar to logical AND, OR is similar to logical OR, whereas NOT is similar to logical NOT. So what is AND? If both operands are true, then this AND will return true. Otherwise, that means true false, false true, false false means false. So this is about what is AND keyword. Next one is OR keyword. If any one of the operand is true, then the result is true. Otherwise, the result is false. So if you take this one, if any one of the operand is true, so here we have both operands are true, so the result is true. Here this operand is true, so result is true. This operand is true, so result is true. Here both the operands are false, so the result is false. So if any one of the operand is true, then the result is true, otherwise the result is false. That is about OR keyword. Next one is NOT. If the expression is true, then NOT will return false value. Whereas if the expression is false, then NOT will return true value. And the next one is IS keyword. IS keyword is mainly useful in order to check whether two objects are same or not. Python is an object-oriented programming language. So everything will be treated as an object. variable is also an object. Okay, let a value is 10, b value is 10. If you want to check whether these two values or whether these two variables are equal or not, then we can use just is operator. If you want to display the result, then we can use print. So print a is b. Here the result of is always a boolean value. So if both variables contain same value, then it returns a true value. Otherwise it returns false value. Okay, here what is a value? 10. What is b value? 20. So they are not equal, so it returns false value. Whereas let us assume that b value is also 10. So now a means 10 value, so b means 10, so both are equal, so it returns true as the result. So is keyword is mainly useful in order to check whether two objects are equal or not. If they are equal, then it returns true value, whereas if they are not equal, then it returns false value. So we can say that the result of is keyword is always a boolean value. In true, t is uppercase letter. In false, f is uppercase letter. And the next one is while for break continue. Okay, so while, it is a looping control statement. If you want to execute a set of statements repeatedly, then we have to use this while loop. Next one is for. It is also a looping control statement. If you want to execute a set of statements repeatedly, then we have to use this for loop. Next one is break continue. Break and continue are used in looping control statements. So if break statement is executed, then the control comes out from the loop. That means that loop execution will be terminated. Okay, so the remaining statements following the loop will be executed. So whenever break statement is executed, then that loop execution will be terminated and the statements following the loop will be executed. Next is continue. Whenever continue statement is executed, then the remaining statements in that iteration will not be executed, but the loop execution continues with next iteration. Now let's see about the next keyword, that is in. It is useful in order to check whether an element is present in a collection or not. In order to maintain a collection of elements, we use list, set, tuple, dictionary. So if we want to check whether an element is present in that collection, then we can make use of in. Suppose if the element is present in the collection, then it returns a true value. Suppose if that element is not present in the collection, then it returns false value. Let's take an example here. Let us take the first one, that is a list. So let the list contains three elements. So a is equal to 10, 20, 30. I have written a statement like this: print 30 in a. So here 30 is present in the list a. So the output here is true. Let us assume that in place of 30 we have written 300. So 300 in a. 300 is not present in a. So the output is false. So this is about in. So next one is return keyword. We know the advantage of the return keyword. It is mainly useful in order to return a value from called function to the calling function. With the help of return statement, we can return only one value from the called function to the calling function. Next one is yield. The major problem with the return statement is by using return statement, we can return only one value. If we want to return more than one value, then it is not possible. In that occasion, we can use this yield keyword. Yield keyword allows us to return a collection. That means yield keyword allows us to return more than one value. Yield keyword returns a generator. So generator means it contains a collection of values. Next keywords are try, accept, finally, rise, assert. So all these are useful while handling the exceptions. We know what is exception. An exception is an error which occurs while the program is executing. So whenever an exception occurs, then the program will get abnormal termination. The remaining statements in the program will not get executed. Now let's see the keywords one by one. The first one is try keyword. Try contains a list of statements that may contains an exception. Let us assume that there is a possibility that that statement may generate an exception. Now we have to place that statement in the try block. So try contains a collection of statements that may generate an exception. Next one is except keyword. It is just like the catch block that we use in Java for handling the exceptions. So catch block contains we know that catch block contains a list of statements that handles the exception. So likewise here, except contains a list of statements that handles the exception. So in while handling the exception, we can have multiple exceptions. Okay, so the first except may handles arithmetic exceptions. The second except black may handles some file related exceptions. Likewise, so except is similar to the catch. Next one is finally. Finally contains a list of statements. The body of the finally will always gets executed if there is an exception or no exception. Okay, so finally block always gets executed when there is an exception or no exception. Next one is rise. Rise is similar to throw keyword that we use in Java. So whenever we use rise, then what will happen is that exception will be raised. So if we want to throw an exception explicitly, then we have to use the rise keyword. So rise keyword is useful in order to raise an exception explicitly, or in order to throw an exception explicitly, then we use rise keyword. Next one is assert. Assert is mainly useful in order to check whether the condition is true or not. If the condition is true, then nothing will happen, nothing will get executed. Whereas if the condition is false, then an assert error will get executed. Let's take an example here. Assert space 10 less than 20. So this condition is true, so nothing will get executed, nothing will get printed. Whereas we have written one more statement like this, assert. So after assert, we always returns a condition 10 greater than 20. This condition is false, so what will happen now? An assert error will get printed. Next one is import. Import is mainly useful in order to import a module. In C we have header files, stdio header file, conivo header file, math header file, like that. Whereas in Java we have packages, okay, like java.io package, java.lang package, java.math package. Likewise we have several packages. In Python we have modules. If we want to import any module, then we use this import statement. That module contains a collection of predefined library functions. We have a module called math module. So import space math. So whenever we import math module, then it contains so many mathematical functions like pi value, sine value, cos value, exponential value, power value. So we can use all those functions in our program. Next one is from keyword. Instead of importing all the functions, I want to make use of only one function, then we can use the from keyword. So from keyword is mainly useful in order to import a single function from the package, or in order to import a sub package from the package, then we use the from keyword. Okay, so we can write as like this. So from let us assume that from math I want to import one statement. So from math import pi. So then what will happen is, instead of all the library functions, only pi will be imported. So in our program we can use only pi now. And the next one is yas keyword. Yas is mainly useful in order to provide an alias name, an alternative name for the module, so that instead of that module name we can use just that alias name. Now let's see an example here. Import math as m. Now m is nothing but an alias name, an alternative name for the module math. Now in place of math we can use as m. So we can write as like this. Let us assume that I want to print pi value. So print m dot pi. So what is m dot pi? What is the value of pi? 3.14. So now 3.14 will get printed. So yas is useful in order to provide an alias or alternative name for the module. So in place of module now we can use just this alias name. Next one is def. Def stands for definition. If you want to define any user defined function in Python, we have to use just def keyword. Next one is pass. Pass doesn't performs anything. Okay, while calling the functions, mainly we use as pass. So whenever we use as pass, then nothing will gets executed. It is just like null. It has no meaning. Next one is global. In C or C++ or Java, we have a global variable concept. So likewise in Python also we have global variable. So we know what is a global variable. Global variables are mainly useful on top of the program. So on top of the class, on top of all the functions, we declare the global variable. So if you declare a global variable, then that variable is useful throughout the program. Whereas in Python programming language allows us to declare a global variable inside a function. Let we have a function called f1. In f1 function, I declared a variable called a, global a. Now this a will becomes the global variable. So we can make use of this a throughout the entire program. So in entire program, we can use as the a. Now let's see about non-local. Non-local is mainly useful in order to access a non-local variable. It is mainly useful if you have nested functions. Nested function means if you define a function inside another function, then it is called as nested function. Let we have a function like this. This is outer function. In f1 we have a variable called a. Next in f1 function we have defined a function called f2. In f2 function we have a variable called b. Then we can access a only inside f1 function only. It is not possible to access this a from f2 function, but I want to access a from f2 also. Then we can declare as like this, non-local a. So whenever we declare like this, then we can access a in f2 function also. So that is the advantage of the non-local. Next one is lambda. It is mainly useful in order to define anonymous functions. Anonymous functions means the functions doesn't have any name. So if you want to define any function without any name, then we have to use this lambda keyword. Next one is del. DEL stands for delete. It is mainly useful in order to deallocate, in order to destroy, in order to release the memory for a variable or object. Let us assume that we have a statement like this, a is equal to 10, DEL a. So whenever the statement is executed, then the memory for a will be deleted. So now it is not possible to access a. And the next one is with. So with is mainly useful in order to handling the files. So if you want to implement file handling in Python, then we use a with keyboard. Next one is the last keyboard is class. Class is mainly useful in order to create a user defined data type. Class is a collection of variables and methods. Class is a collection of objects. So if you want to create any class, then we use this class keyword. Okay, so we will discuss all these keywords in detail in program wise, okay, in the later videos. So this is about keywords in Python programming language.